Hello everyone, this is the lecture number 30 of the lecture series of Naval Architecture made for MEO examination. In this class, we will continue with the transverse stability of the ship. Specifically, I am going to cover the free surface effect. First of all, try to understand what is the meaning of a free surface effect. We know that in a ship, you will find a variety of the tanks are available. If this tanks is partially filled, because of the partial fullfulness of this tank, there will be a two effects will come on the ship structure. First is the structural effect, and the second one is the stability aspect. Now, what is the meaning of a structural effect? Consider that the double bottom of the ship. In the double bottom, if you find that it is a partially filled, it means there will be some space available in the double bottom tank for the movement of the liquid in the double bottom. Now, because of some external agency, ship is going to start rolling about the x-axis, which is perpendicular to the screen in this case. When the ship is start rolling, the liquid which is present inside the tank will also start oscillating within the tank, and this water will go and strike on the side of the tank, and because of that there will be a lot of the loads will come on the side of the tank, and this reason the structural integrity of the DB tank may get lost. The same thing is applicable in all the cases, in all the tanks. So this is the effect of the free surface if you think about the structural point of view. Now the second point is the effect of this free surface on the stability of the ship. Now, because of the free surface effect, the stability of the ship is going to reduce. We know that the stability of the ship is depends on the metacentric height. For any ship, you want to say that whether the ship is stable, unstable or the neutral equilibrium, you have to see the value of a GM only. If the GM is positive, we will say the ship is stable, GM is negative, ship is unstable. If the GM is zero, we can say that the ship is a neutral. It means the stability of the ship is depends on the GM only. Now what I am saying here, because of the free surface effect, the stability of the ship is going to reduce. If the stability is reducing, it means that there will be a reduction in the value of a GM. So how much the reduction of the GM will be there, that all the things we will discuss now. And how it will reduce the GM value, these things we will discuss. Then we will discuss what is the remedial action you will take during the design of the ship to avoid this free surface effect. So let's start the discussion on the free surface effect. You can see on the screen, I have drawn the two diagrams, the diagram A and the diagram B, both are a transverse view of the ship. You can see here, there is a double bottom here, and this double bottom is completely filled with the liquid. Now the topic which I am discussing here, that is applicable for the all the tanks. The free surface effect can occur in all the tanks, but here I am taking example as a double bottom. Okay, so for other tanks also the procedure will be remain same, the effect of the free surface will be remain same. In this case I am taking the example as a double bottom tank. In short, we will call as a DB tank. Now you can see here, the double bottom tank is completely filled with the liquid, whatever may be the liquid. So it is filled with the liquid. You can see the small g is the center of gravity location of the water which is present in the tank. Now in this case, this tank is completely filled. So the center of gravity of the water present in the tank is lying on the center line only. Capital B is the center of buoyancy of the whole ship. Capital G is the center of gravity of the whole ship, meta center of the whole ship. K is the keel. Now the total weight of the ship is going to act through the center of gravity of the ship. Now because of some external agency like a wave or wind, there will be some heeling moment generated towards the starboard side. Now because of that, the ship has inclined, or you can say heeled, towards the starboard side. Now you can see here, there is no space available in the double bottom for the movement of the liquid. So this liquid is work like a solid part only, the solid object only. There is no movement of the water within the DB tank in this case. So there is no movement of a center of gravity of the water which is present in the double bottom. So center of gravity of the water present in the double bottom will remain on the center line only after the inclination, after the heeling of the ship. So what are the things we are going to change? When the ship is inclined towards the starboard side, there will be an increment in the volume towards the starboard side, and the same amount of the volume is reduced towards the port side. If you find out the new center of buoyancy location, and the new center of buoyancy is the centroid of underwater volume, in this case, when the ship is inclined, the center of buoyancy is shifting from B to B1, somewhere here. So through this B1, we know that the buoyant force is going to act, and that will intersect the center line somewhere. That point is a metacenter, and this the line of action of the buoyant force made some angle with the center line. That angle is a heeling angle theta. From the G, you put the perpendicular on the line of action of the buoyant force, that is a GZ, and we will call as a lever. In this case, this lever is a righting lever. Why? If you take the moment about a G, the moment which is generating, that is a buoyant force into the GZ, we know that this buoyant force is always equal to the weight. I can write W into GZ, and so this movement is bringing the ship back to its original position. So we will call this movement as the righting movement. In general, we will call it the movement of static stability, that is W into GZ. Now for the small angle, we can write GZ is equal to GM sin theta. About this we have discussed in the earlier classes. So here, although the water is present or the liquid is present in the tank, but it is completely filled. In this case, it is working as a normal condition only. But if the double bottom is partially filled, it means, suppose I have a same ship and the double bottom, you can see here, it is a partially filled. You can see here, there will be some amount of the space is available in the double bottom for the movement of the liquid present in the double bottom. So the blue color, you can see there is some liquid inside the tank, but this double bottom tank is not completely filled. So because of the some heeling movement, for example toward the starboard side, there will be some space available inside the tank, so that the liquid will start moving towards the starboard side, which you can see here. So now liquid is moved towards the starboard side. Initially, when the ship is there in upright condition, the center of gravity of the liquid is at the center line of the ship, that is a G. But when the ship is inclined towards the starboard side, there will be a movement of the center of gravity from G to G1. Wherever the maximum liquid, that direction the center of gravity will move. Now it's like it is shifting the weight towards the starboard side. It's like you have shifted the weight towards the starboard side. Although this weight is not a solid weight, it is a liquid, but still that liquid is having some amount of the weight. So it is shifted towards the starboard side. So at that particular instant the time I am talking, so center of gravity of the whole ship will also start moving from capital G to the new G, that is a G1. So two things you have to keep in your mind. The line which I have drawn here, that is a small g to g1, this line and capital G to G1, this line, both are parallel to each other. Try to recall the earlier classes. Now if I ask, what is the GM value here? When the ship is inclined, at this instant point, what is the GM value? You cannot calculate the GM value. Because in this case, the new center of gravity G1 is not on the center line of the ship. So for that purpose, what we are going to do now? We are going to draw one line that is passing through G1 and that will intersect the center line somewhere here. That point, let me call GV. V stands for virtual, and this GV we will call as a virtual center of gravity. Now, before the ship is inclined towards the starboard side, the metacentric height is GM, capital G to M. Now, when the ship is inclined towards the starboard side, the new metacentric height is came into the picture, that is GVM. So this is the new metacentric height, and the GV is called as a virtual center of gravity. So if I ask what is the new metacentric height here, it will be GVM is equal to GM is the old center of gravity minus the loss of a metacentric height, that is a GGV. So this much amount of loss we got in a metacentric height. So initial metacentric height is a GM. There will be a loss of a metacentric height, that is a G to GV. And that then after that we can calculate the new metacentric height, that is a GVM. You can see here, if you think about the numerical value, consider the GM, initial GM is 1.5. Now after doing this calculation, because of the free surface effect, there will be a loss of the metacentric height, that is GGV. Consider that it may be a 0.5. So new metacentric height will be 1 meter. So because of the free surface effect, the metacentric height is reduced from 1.5 to 1 meter. So as the metacentric height is reduces, obviously the lever also going to change. If you want to find out the lever here, it will be from the GV, you put the perpendicular on the line of action of the buoyant force, that is this one. So this point is ZV. So the new writing lever will be GVZV. Earlier it was a GZ. So you can see here, new writing lever has reduced from the GZ to GVZV. So as the writing lever reduces compared to earlier, the writing moment also going to reduce. As the writing moment reduces, the stability of the ship may get reduced. Sometimes it may happen like that this GV will go above the meta center also. If the free surface effect is too much, that time this GV may go above the meta center. So that time, at that particular instant I am talking again, that will be a negative metacentric height. So this GVM, the metacentric height which we got because of the free surface effect, sometimes we will call GVM, we will call it as a GM fluid. We will call it as a GM fluid. Now the question remains as it is. How to calculate the loss of a metacentric height, that is a GGV. So to calculate this GGV, we have one formula available with us. So this is the formula of the free surface effect, that is a GGV. We can call the GGV, we can call the free surface effect, we can call it the virtual loss of a GM. So what is the formula here? That is I by W into rho into 1 by N square. And that will come in a meters. So what is this I here? I is the moment of inertia of the tank. For example, consider I am looking the tank in the top. It will be look like this. Consider again it is a rectangle here. So this is the beam of this tank and this is the length of the tank. This is the x-axis about which this tank is going to oscillate like this. This is the top view of the trunk. Now if I ask what is the moment of inertia about x-axis, it will be lb cube by 12. Capital W is the displacement of a ship. Rho is the density of the liquid present in the tank. Please try to understand this. This is not a density of the fluid where the ship is floating. This is the density of the liquid which is present in the tank into 1 by n square. Now what is this n? N is the number of a compartment in the tank. Now let's consider the double bottom tank. So if you see, you have a double bottom here. And in this double bottom, there is only one compartment. There is no partition here along the longitudinal direction. Perpendicular to the screen, that is the length of the ship, that is the longitudinal direction. So if you see here, the number of tank is only one. So you can take this n is a 1. Suppose if I say that there is a one watertight center girder is there in my ship like this. So in this case there will be a two watertight compartments, so that time n becomes 2. If I say there are two side girders on either side and that also watertight, provided it should be a watertight, so there will be now 1, 2, 3, 4, there are 4 watertight compartments are there, so that time n is equal to 4. So what are the inferences you will get from this free surface effect formula, that is a GGV? Always our task is to reduce this GGV. Why I am saying that? What is the new metacentric height, that is a GVM, is equal to GM minus GGV. Let's take some numerical value here. Initial GM before the free surface effect, consider it is a 1.5. If GGV is a large, if the GGV is a large, it means that 1.5 minus that large number, then this GVM will be very very small. If the GVM is small, it means that the stability of the ship will be less. So always keep in your mind, this GGV value should be always as much as a minimum. If this value is a minimum, then GVM will be always maximum, because the GM is fixed for the particular ship before the free surface effect. So how to get this GGV value is very small. For that purpose, you try to understand this formula. In this case, you can see the free GGV is inversely proportional to the n square. It means if you have n is very large, then this GGV will be very small. It means you have more number of compartments longitudinally, then the free surface effect will be very very less. So let's try to understand this by taking some animation, then we will go for the numerical. You can see here, there is a one ship here, again similar ship. You can see here, the left side ship is there and the right side ship, both are filled with the liquid, but the first ship is there, which is on the left side, it doesn't have any longitudinal compartment. But the right side ship having the 4 longitudinal compartments are there. Now for the same heeling movement, you can see the first ship which is there at the left side, it is a sinking, you can say capsizing. The second picture you can see the ship is not capsizing for the same heeling movement. So this is the advantage of the creating the compartments inside the tank. Let's solve a small numerical to understand this concept. A ship of a 6000 tons displacement, means it is a weight of the ship is given, floating in a salt water, has a double bottom tank, 20 meter length, 12 meter wide and 2 meter depth, which is divided at the center line. Means if you see the transverse view of the double bottom, it will be like this, which is divided at the center line. It means that N is equal to 2 here. And is partially filled with the oil. The relative density is 0.82. The relative density is 0.82. It means that the density will be 0.82 multiplied by 1000. It will be in a kg per meter cube. But I want this density in a tons per meter cube. It will be 0.82 tons per meter cube. Find the virtual loss of the GM due to the free surface of an oil. Now the formula for the calculation of the virtual loss of the GM is I by W into rho oil, means density of the oil, into 1 by N square. I is LB cube by 12. Rho is the density of the liquid which is present in the tank, into 1 by W into 1 by N square. If you substitute all the values here, you will get the virtual loss of a GM is 0.098 meter. It means this is a GGV only. The virtual loss of the GM means it is a GGV only. I hope everything is clear. In the next class, we will do two more numericals are there, and that numericals is very, very important for the knowledge point of view as well as for the exam point of view. So all of you please watch the next lecture, that is a lecture number 31 on the free surface effect, where we are going to solve the two numericals on the free surface effect. At the same time, in that numerical you will find a little bit of variety, and that is a very challenging numerical on the free surface effect. Thank you very much.